And the youth committee basically consulted with our youth in the community on the actual construction, obviously, WP, the wonderful job, the timeframe that we had, the budget that we worked with. We also had a number of other people involved. Tim Sear, Tim Murray, worked tirelessly in the past week. He's been working late every day. This is a youth worker for the past 3 years. Hey, boy.
And that's the role of the council. The council also has to be, and they are, in this First Nation, I am proud to say that the council of this First Nation are actively involved. And I don't have to be the one doing that, it's the council doing that. And when these things become reality, we all benefit. We all benefit from our parents sending their youth here to learn. We all benefit from our youth educating themselves. Because tomorrow will be a brighter day. Those are some of the things. And why I said those things is so our youth that are here, when you assemble here, it's not just a playtime. It's a learning time. It's a respect time. It's a reminisce time. That's what this is. This is what you wanted. I want to thank the Indigenous Northern Affairs Canada, Mr. McGuire, Bob McGuire, at least here today. I want to thank, of course, the Federation of Sovereign Indigenous Nations, Professor Ross here. And I want to thank the Vice of Health Council, Mr. Edmund Bowler, here. And I want to thank all the Paul attending today. And last but not least is my good friend, Mr. Darrell DeBoff. He's our director of the Tuscarawas Family Services. Their task is to ensure the safety and protection of children. And how does that relate to the youth center? Because they'll be involved in this. Our school will be involved in this. So everybody has to be involved with the First Nation in order to make it succeed. In closing, I want to thank our youth. And Ryan that cut the ribbon this morning. And again, I want to thank. Is anyone I missed? I apologize. But I want to thank Councilor Arnold. And I want to thank all those staff at CASPA that chipped in wherever they can. And last but not least, the artwork you see is our whole First Nation people. With that, tomorrow's day, tomorrow will be a brighter day, the future looks even better. So with that, each and every one of you, to our youth, to our women, to our elders, to our leadership, to our guests, to the people of Pasqua, hi hi, may you all enjoy the day. Thank you.
Like
here is a representative from Indigenous and Northern Affairs, Mr. Rob White. Congratulations on opening this impressive new facility. This grand opening represents the culmination of your committee's hard work and dedication, which was the driving force behind this important and exciting project. Back in the fall of 2016, when the sod was first turned, we knew there was plenty of work ahead to complete this project. And now we get to take the exciting step and satisfying final step together. This project is a shining example of the collaboration required when it comes to developing new culture, youth, and recreation infrastructure. These facilities provide an important focal point for community activities and First Nation communities. We also know that investing in future generations will reap both immediate and long-term benefits. Cultural and recreational infrastructure plays a vital role in improving the social fabric of First Nations. But let's remember that infrastructure is more than just concrete, water pipes, roads, and bridges. It's what connects individuals and families to their communities and allows them to be active participants socially and economically. Investing in social infrastructure in Indigenous communities is a key pillar of the Government of Canada's strategy. Inclusive growth. Your project is an example of a local vision and investments that will lay the foundation for a long-term investment strategy in First Nation community infrastructure with a focus on building healthy, safe, and prosperous communities. This long-term plan will build a lasting legacy for this community and for generations to come. In closing, congratulations on the completion of this. My department is very proud to have invested $750,000 towards and to assist your community in making this happen. Please know that INAC continues to be committed to working in partnership with all of you to support the well-being of First Nation children and families in this community and on the earth. Together, we will continue to work with each other to make real change for First Nation children. Thank you.
I'd like to thank you for the invitation. that's going forward. There are a couple of things that I want to point out about this building that some folks should know. This was designed with all the way to face itself. That was done on purpose, and that was much natural way that was possible. I did hear a comment in here about the exterior of the building. That was done on purpose too, to give a more natural aesthetic type of look. The facility is designed in such a way that can be expanded to the west. So that's why we're finding things like the canopy at that part corner, so that the building does expand. There's a common question about how the existing building is, that's 2,500 square feet. Okay? And it's got all the latest energy efficient, electric, gas efficiency items that.
Thank you.
are here today as well to come and celebrate this, this wonderful, wonderful initiative. Let's call it that. The elders love you, and they want to make sure that you succeed. And I just want to acknowledge, half the First Nation Council, we have some of our council members here. We have Jessica Gordon, if you would stand up and say hello to the people. Not enough activities to do on the reserve.
there's no place to gather. You're always looking for activities or something to do, something to keep them busy, something that they have fun with, somewhere where they can go. And this center is going to be that place for our young people. So I want to encourage you to come here, encourage you to sit with the elders, understand that knowledge, language, and culture is a huge part of the efforts that are being made today to reconnect. And that's important. So just want to help Pasco First Nation celebrate this day, and I want to acknowledge my roots here. My mother was born on the First Nation, my late mother. My grandmother, Justine Johns, the Johns clan, my relatives that are still here. I'm proud of my cousin Chi, or Nadine. I know how tough it was for her to come up here and speak. So just want to acknowledge Pasqua for the elders, the leadership, the parents, the community, the operations staff, and the youth for all working together, all having a hand in this. And Fabian, for you for taking that lead role in making this happen for everybody. So with that, we've got a gift. I want to call on Leticia and Ryan, the two youth representatives from Pasqua, to accept the gift from the Toronto Council.
Which is the picture. There you go.
morning when I was walking around, I was silent. Because we did get some funding for a project that we should be paid for. Yeah, I just got a call and I was like, I didn't think we'd get it. So I talked to him.
sincere gratitude to our council, because they're of the view that things need to get done, we can do it ourselves. And many of the things that happen on our First Nation is built by your own people. And employed by your own First Nation businesses. So that's why I want to commend WP, I want to commend the council for making those decisions. Not only on the youth center. I was talking to Mr. McGuire on the side that he was asking about the homes. And I explained to him that in the last 6 years, over 6 years, we built 63 homes from our own people. Because our own people built those homes. So I'm proud to be the chief of this First Nation. I'm proud to be a band member of this First Nation when I'm no longer chief. And I will be, if elected. And I just want to, in closing, I want to say, look around, because that fridge has Wi-Fi. I couldn't believe it, that fridge has Wi-Fi. And you can play music off it. And I want a fridge like that. But when you look at these pictures of encouragement, those are our own people. These are our band members, Tyree, Garth, Lana. Isabel Keepness is our next door neighbor, but she's always attended our sessions. Those are your children, youth. Those are people from this reserve. Where they're trying to go and what they've done. So again, I want to thank Fabian for all that he's done, to the council, to the youth, to each and every one that made this possible. I have any questions? Thank you.
Voice.
And then we can all head over to